Good day, fellow students of criminology. Today we will study about police intelligence. This is one of the subjects in the criminology licensure board examination. Actually, maraming kinukuhang questions dito. So, it is very important for us to have a background knowledge and review regarding police intelligence. So before going further, I prepared a PowerPoint presentation for us to facilitate our learning and to easily understand what is police intelligence all about. This is just the summary and the most important points in the study of police intelligence. First, let us know that different intelligence organizations around the world. Sometimes, laging lumalabas ang mga organizations na to sa board examination. First, we have the Central Intelligence Agency or the CIA. Ito ang largest intelligence organization sa United States of America. This is responsible for gathering data from other countries that could impact U.S. policy. So, ang mga CIA nakakalat sa buong mundo serving the United States. The CIA is charged with gathering, correlating, evaluating, and disseminating intelligence affecting national security of the United States of America. It was formerly called Office of Strategic Services or OSS until it formally became the CIA with the passage of the National Security Act of 1947. So, tanda natin, pag CIA, United States of America. And we have Mossad. Alam na natin dati sa college na ang Mossad ay ang intelligence agency ng Israel. Mossad is responsible for intelligence collection and covert operations, including paramilitary activities. It is one of the main entities in Israeli intelligence community, along with Aman, or their military intelligence, and Shin Bet, yung kanilang internal security. But the director of Mossad directly reports to the Prime Minister of Israel. Mossad is Israel's intelligence agency responsible for gathering intelligence and secret operations concerned with national security and counter-terrorism. So yung Mossad, yun yung ang concern niya is national security ng Israel at pati counter-terrorism. So we have Hamossad, Le Mudinole, Tafkidim, Meyohadim. In short, Mossad, which has a meaning the Institute for Intelligence and Special Tasks. So baka lumabas sa exam, ano yung ibig sabihin ng Hamossad, Le Mudinole, Tafkidim, Meyohadim? So it means the Institute for Intelligence and Special Tasks. Tandaan, ang Mossad sa Israel. Sa United Kingdom naman, meron silang tinatawag na Military Intelligence Department 5 or MI5. It is the United Kingdom's domestic counterintelligence and security agency and is part of its intelligence machinery alongside with the Secret Intelligence Service. It is now responsible for national security and counter-espionage activities. Ang tawag sa kanila, Military Intelligence Section 5 or MI5. So, ang concern nila is domestic counterintelligence. While sa kanilang foreign intelligence service, meron silang tinatawag na Military Intelligence Department 6 or MI6. It is the Foreign Intelligence Service of the United Kingdom. It is now known as Secret Intelligence Service. Its primary role is to provide intelligence gathered from foreign sources in support of national security, defense, and foreign economic policies. So para hindi tayo malito, sa domestic counterintelligence ng United Kingdom, mayroon silang Military Intelligence Department 5. Sa kanilang Foreign Intelligence Service, mayroon silang Military Intelligence Department 6. So let's go on. We have also the Komitet Gosudars Vinoy Besopasnosti. In short, ito yung tinatawag na KGB. Okay? KGB is one of the most feared intelligence services in the world. Kinakatakutan ito. Why? It is feared by other organizations as well as its own people. It is translated as the Committee for State Security or Komitet Gosudars Vinoy Besopasnosti or KGB. It was the secret police force of the Soviet Union mula 1954 to 1991. Then next, sa Pilipinas, dito sa atin, meron tayong sariling intelligence agency. Ito yung National Intelligence Coordinating Agency or NICA. It is the primary intelligence gathering and analysis arm of the Philippine government in charge of carrying out overt, covert, and clandestine intelligence programs of the Philippines. Ang kanilang motto, baka lumabas sa exam, intelligence is security. So, we have our own NICA, National Intelligence Coordinating Agency. NICA is formerly known as NISA during the time of martial law, during the time of President Ferdinand Marcos, or the National Intelligence Service Agency, NISA. Now, we must define first what is intelligence or what do we mean by the word or by the term intelligence. Intelligence is being defined as the product resulting from the collection, evaluation, analysis, integration, and interpretation of all available information and which is used as a guide in the formulation of plans, policies, and programs. So ito na yung end result ng lahat ng mga nakolektang information, na-evaluate, na-analyze, then na-integrate and interpreted. And it is being used para magplano, maggumawa ng mga policies and programs. So end product ito. Sometimes this is also defined as a raw data that have undergone the process of the intelligence cycle. So, yung intelligence cycle, yung collection, evaluation, analysis, yung tinatawag na dissemination. So, mamaya, mapag-aralan natin yan. So, intelligence is also defined as the product resulting from the collection, evaluation, analysis, interpretation, integration of all available information which concerns one or more aspects of human activity which should be known in advance in order to initiate a particular course of action. So, sinasabi dito, mayroon tayong kailangang malaman out of different available informations para makagawa tayo ng tinatawag na courses of action in the future. So yan ang intelligence. So ang pinaka keyword natin is the end product or the product resulting from the yung intelligence cycle: collection, evaluation, analysis, integration, and interpretation of all available information. Yan po ang simple definition ng intelligence. Okay. What are the functions of intelligence? It is nice to know that there are different functions of intelligence. So first, let us study how to collect and procure information. The collection or procurement of information. What do we mean by the word procurement? If we say procurement, it is the aggressive effort to acquire certain information which may not be readily available. So mag-procure ka pa lang, aalamin mo pa lang. Yan. So mag-exert ka ng effort to acquire them. Yan tinawag na procurement. Because those informations are not readily available. How about the term information? What do we mean by the term information? Information is a communicated knowledge by others, obtained by personal study, investigation, research, analysis, and observation. So ito yung mga information na to, ito yung mga ibinibigay sa atin ng iba or na-obtain natin by, yun nga, personal studying, investigation, product of research, product of analysis, and even mere observation. That is information. There are two methods of collecting information. So yung mga information na yan, para ma-collect natin, there are two methods, either by overt or by covert. Pag sinabi natin overt, this is an open collection of raw information. So kukuha ka lang, hindi ka na kailangang mag-disguise or gumawa ng mga strategies kasi open naman na kukuha. So ang tawag dyan, overt collection. While kung tinatawag nating covert collection, ito yung tinatawag na secret collection of raw information. Palihim na pagkuha ng mga informasyon. So kung sekreto ang pagkuha, hindi kailangan malaman ng iba, tawag yan covert. So overt is open collection of information, while covert is secret collection of raw information. There are two kinds of target. In the procurement and collection of information, mayroon tayong tinatawag na targets. So these targets can be a soft target or a hard target. Pag sinabi nating soft target, one who is easy to get information from. So madali lang kunin yung impormasyon. Soft target lang siya. But if it is a hard target, it is very difficult to acquire information. Mahirapan tayo, hindi basta-basta kukuha. Okay? So kailangan gumawa tayo ng effort talaga. While yung soft target, kahit hindi ka na mag-effort, madali mo lang itong makukuha. Pero pag mahirap, ang tawag natin dyan, hard target. Okay. So sa pagkuha at pag-procure ng information, mayroon tayong mga tinatawag na mga agents used in information procurement. Okay. Mayroon tayong tinatawag na agent in place. Sino ito? Agent in place is recruited by the intelligence service from within a highly sensitive target. So, magre-recruit tayo ng agent natin doon mismo sa lugar kung saan tayo kukuha ng information. Ang tawag doon, agent in place. Meron tayong tinatawag na double agent. Yung double agent na yan is simply a captured agent used by his captors. Okay? So, nahuli siya at gagamitin natin siya para makuhanan ng impormasyon. Ang tawag sa kanya ngayon ay double agent. Meron din tayo tinatawag na expendable agent. Sino tong expendable agent? An agent through whom false information is leaked to the enemy. So, may mga false information, ipapalik natin sa isang expendable agent. Siya ang magpapakalat ng maling impormasyon sa ating mga kalaban. So, ang tawag doon, expendable agent. Mayroon din tayong tinatawag na penetration agent. Sino tong penetration agent na to? Ang penetration agent, ito yung mga agent na pumupunta sa mga kalaban, nag-gather ng information, at bumabalik sa atin para ibigay yung mga nakuha ng information. Sometimes, ito yung matinatawag na DPA or deep penetration agent. Sila yung papasok sa ating mga enemies, enemy place, para mag-gather ng information, magpapanggap doon, then lahat ng information niya ibibigay sa atin. So, penetration agent ang tawag doon. Meron din tayo tinatawag na agent of influence. These are agents who uses influence to gather information. Ito yung mga ma-influensyang tao na ginagamit nila yung kanilang connection, influence para makagather ng information. So, ang tawag sa kanila, agent of influence. Then, we also have a so-called agent provocateur. Sila yung mga agent na gumagamit ng provocation para makagather ng information, makikipag-away, yan. Para at least, through that provocation, makakakuha sila ng information. Okay? So, let's proceed to the evaluation of information which is then becomes intelligence. Ngayon, yung nakuha nating mga impormasyon na binigay ng different agents natin sa anumang pamamaraan, okay, kung sino man yung kumuha, yung mga information na yan ay magiging intelligence. Okay? So, mayroon tayong process na tinatawag na evaluation. What do we mean by evaluation? Evaluation means critical appraisal of an item of information to determine its pertinence, reliability, and accuracy. So, hindi lahat ng information na binibigay natin ay tatanggapin na lang natin. Yung mga information na yan ay dadaan sa tinatawag na evaluation process. So, kailangan natin silang evaluate para malaman natin kung pertinent ba yan, kailangan ba yan, totoo ba yan, reliable ba yan, okay, or kung accurate ba yan. So, kailangan nating evaluate. Kasi napaka-useless ang isang information na hindi dumadaan sa evaluation process. Then, after evaluating, dito na tayo pupunta sa tinatawag na dissemination of intelligence to those who need it. So, lahat ng evaluated information na proseso, ibibigay na natin sa tamang tao na gagamit dito. So, kadalasan yan yung mga higher ups na natin or higher authorities. Now, there are different processes or different steps in the processing of information. Maraming tayong tinatawag na first step is recording. Recording means reducing the information into writing. So, kailangan lahat ng information na yan ay kailangan i-record natin. We will reduce them into black and white. So, gagawa tayo ng reports para at least magkaroon tayo ng records. Then next is yung tinatawag na evaluation. So, same with na-discuss natin, this is the critical appraisal of an item of information to determine its pertinence, reliability, and accuracy. So, lahat ng information natin na nakarating sa atin by verbal or by written, i-evaluate natin. Then after evaluation, we will now interpret those informations by the process of interpretation. Interpretation determines the significance of the information in relation to what is already known. It is the result of critical judgment involving, okay, this is how to interpret, analysis. So analysis is the sorting of evaluated information to isolate the significant elements with respect to mission. So ina-analyze natin, inihiwalay na natin yung mga significant information which is related or in connection sa gagawin nating mission. So mga hindi naman kailangan, so hindi na natin isasali, isusort out na natin. So ang mga kailangan lang natin na kunin ay yung mga pertinent na information sa mission. Then, we will proceed to the next process which is integration. Pag sinabing integration, it is the combination of elements in isolated analysis with other known information. So, integrate natin, i-correlate na natin, i-connect na natin yung mga gathered information natin, okay, sa mga known information para makabuo tayo ng plano. Okay? So, yun yung tinatawag na integration. So, balikan natin. We have the recording. I-reduce natin into writing. Then, we have to evaluate yung mga items of information na nag-gather natin para makita natin kung pertinent ba to, reliable, or accurate. Then, we go to the interpretation process. Interpret na natin using analysis and integration. Analyze mo natin yung significant sa hindi with respect to the mission, and we will integrate together yung mga gathered pertinent, accurate, and reliable information with other known information. So, yun yung process of or processing of information. Now, so, ang na-topic natin is general concept ng intelligence. Pupunta na tayo sa specific topic natin, which is police intelligence. So, first, let us understand what is police intelligence. Police intelligence is the product resulting from the collection, evaluation, analysis, integration, and interpretation of all available information which concerns one or more aspects of the criminal environment which is immediately or potentially significant to police planning. So, lahat ng gagawin natin, okay, lahat ng nakolekta, na-evaluate, na-analyze, na-integrate, at na-interpret na available information na magagamit natin sa tinatawag na police planning, ang tawag dyan, police intelligence. Okay, another definition is that police intelligence is the gathering of information regarding the activities of criminals and those that violate the law for the purpose of obtaining evidence to facilitate their arrest and forestall their plans to commit crime. So, ang gamit ng police intelligence din is to gather information with regards to the activities of criminal groups, mga criminals natin, or to those who violate our laws, purposely to obtain evidence or pieces of evidence for to facilitate their arrest, their apprehension, and also to forestall their plans to commit further crimes. So, yun ang gamit ng police intelligence natin. Now, there are two types, main types of police intelligence. We have the strategic intelligence and the line intelligence. Ano ba pinagkaiba ng dalawa na to? If we say strategic intelligence, these are intelligence information which is primary long range in nature and with little immediate operational value. So, iniipon lang natin ito Okay? Hindi pa naman kailangan. Pero, in the long range, magiging importante ito. Okay? Kailangan natin ito in the future. But if, kung ito ay tinatawag na line intelligence, this is an intelligence information which is of an immediate nature. So, pag sinabing line intelligence, immediate nature, kailangan na, okay, may immediate importance na siya and vital for the more effective police operation and planning. Okay? So, let us test ourselves sa mga nagre-review. It is the end result of intelligence processing. So, end result na to. So, ang pagpipilian natin, strategic intelligence, letter A, B, information, C, raw information, D, intelligence. So, alam kong alam niyo yung sagot na yan. So, sagutin na lang ninyo. Napakadali lang yan. Hindi ko sabihin yung sagot para at least magkaroon kayo ng effort na mag-review sa na-discuss natin. Ito. Next question. This is Israel's intelligence agency. So, dun sa tanong pa lang, alam na natin. Israel's intelligence agency responsible for gathering intelligence and secret operations concerned with national security and counterterrorism. So, ang pagpipilian natin, we have NICA, B, CIA, C, M16, D, KGB, NE, Mossad. So, pag Israel, alam mo na yan. Okay? Alam na natin ang NICA sa Pilipinas yan, ang CIA sa Amerika, ang M16 sa United Kingdom, okay? Yung KGB, Soviet Union, siyempre, ang Mossad, alam na ninyo. Okay. Now, yung NICA is an acronym that stands for what? Ito ba ay National International Council of Agents? B, National Intelligence Council Agency? C, National Investigation of Criminal Affairs? D, National Intelligence Coordination Agency. So, mamimili kayo dyan. So, balikan ninyo yung tinapik natin, na-discuss natin, masasagot ninyo. Now, anong kaibahan ng police intelligence sa military intelligence? Sa military intelligence, this refers to the knowledge by the military institution essential in the preparation and execution of military plans, policies, and programs. So, pagka military ang gumagamit, ang tawag dyan, military intelligence. Paggamit sa police, police intelligence. Now, in general, there are principles of intelligence, either military or police. Ito na yung mga principles of intelligence. We have first objectivity. Ano ibig sabihin ng objectivity? Intelligence must be based on the decision maker's own plans and intention. So, mayroon kang objective. Mayroon kang purpose. Saan mo gagamitin yung intelligence na yan? Okay? So, there should be unity between knowledge and action. So, yung knowledge of different information na yan at saka yung magiging plan of actions mo. Dapat in harmony sila. Meron silang uniformity. Then we also have a principle of interdependence. Intelligence is artificially divided into component elements which on its own has its purpose and importance, but each component must remain an essential part of a unity. Okay? So, mayroon tinatawag na interdependence. Kakaroon ng division ng different component elements. May kanya-kanyang purpose, may kanya-kanyang importance. But yung mga components na to is still magiging parte ng whole part or essential part of that component. So interdependence. Then we have also the principle of continuity. What do we mean by this? Intelligence must be continuous. So dapat tuloy-tuloy. Each subsequent event has been consequent of events preceding. So dapat, pag ito nakuha mo, tuloy-tuloy yan, hindi dapat napuputol. The events of the present are products or result of the events of the past. So may connection yung mga nakaraan sa mga nangyayari ngayon. So dapat makita natin yung tinatawag na continuity. Continuity of intelligence. We have also communication. Intelligence must be communicated to all the decision makers in a manner that they will be understood so that the intelligence is utilized by those who need it. So dapat yung mga available intelligence natin is na i-communicate natin sa tamang tao, sa mga tamang authorities, para magamit naman nila sa decision making nila. Okay? So useless ang intelligence na hindi mo na i-communicate, so hindi rin nagagamit. So that's it. Then we have the selection principle. Intelligence should be essential and pertinent to the purpose at hand. So ano ba yung purpose mo sa intelligence na yan? So kailangan i-select mo ano yung pertinent. Okay, i-sort out mo ano yung kailangan sa hindi kailangan. Because only relevant and significant information should form part of intelligence. Yung mga hindi relevant, huwag mo nang isama. I-sort out mo siya. Okay? Then, intelligence must be timely or dapat magkaroon ng timeliness. Intelligence must be communicated to the decision maker at the appropriate time to permit its most effective use. So, dapat timely. Kasi pag late mo nang isinabmit yung intelligence or information mo na yan at hindi na magagamit, useless na yan. Yung sabi nga nila, anihin mo pa ang damo kung patay na ang kabayo, parang ganun. Then we have security. Security is achieved by measures which intelligence takes to protect and preserve the integrity of its organization, personnel, methods, sources, information, and results of its activities. So dapat secured. Okay? Dapat meron tayong protection para ma-preserve natin yung integrity ng intelligence ng ating organisasyon. Hindi dapat niya malaman ng iba. So, mayroon tayong tinatawag na secrecy ng mga intelligence natin. Hindi dapat malaman ng mga tao na hindi dapat makaalam ng intelligence information na yan. Now, there are different kinds of intelligence. First, we have the national intelligence. The national intelligence is the total product of intelligence developed from information obtained from various departments and agencies of the government and from other sources outside the government. It covers the broad aspects of national policy and security. So, ang keyword dito is national, national policy and security. It is of concern to more than one agency and it's beyond the responsibility of a single agency. So, lahat ng agency ng ating bansa, okay, dapat tumulong, dapat magbigay, okay, makikooperate, okay, because it involves our national policy and security. So, we call that national intelligence. We also have a departmental intelligence. That intelligence required or produced by the line departments. Okay, yung different departments consisting of our national government, so may kanya-kanyang department intelligence. And agencies of the government needed in carrying out the respective mandates and responsibilities. So katulad ng Philippine National Police, may sarili sila yan. Ang Armed Forces of the Philippines, okay, ang Department of Interior and Local Government, at lahat ng ahensya, may sarili silang tinatawag na departmental intelligence. Serves as components of national intelligence. So sa national intelligence, lahat ng departments, agencies, they serve as component. They belong to one national intelligence. We have also the so-called military intelligence. Sabi nga natin, this intelligence is used in the preparation of military policies, plans, and programs. It includes yung tinatawag natin na strategic and combat intelligence. Okay. Let us explain what is strategic intelligence. Strategic intelligence is the knowledge pertaining to the vulnerabilities. Pag sinabi natin vulnerabilities, kahinaan, capabilities, and probable courses of action of foreign nations. So alam natin anong kahinaan ng ating makalabang bansa, okay, kaalyadong bansa, yung capabilities nila, okay, at mga probable courses of actions. Required by national planners for national security in time of peace and as the basis for projected military operations in times of war. It has the following components. Mayroon tayong acronym dito na PESPAGS. First, political intelligence. So more on politics. The second is economic intelligence, more on economy. The next is sociological intelligence, pertains to society. Then, technological intelligence, yung mga advancements sa technologies. Then, the biographical intelligence, the armed forces intelligence, the geographical intelligence, yung geography ng country na yan, and the scientific and technical intelligence. Okay? For easy memorization, we have the PESPAGS. This is just a nice to know. Okay. So, strategic intelligence involves foreign nations. So, ginagamit ito ng mga national planners natin for national security. Either in time of peace and in time of war. While sa combat intelligence natin, combat intelligence is the knowledge of the enemy, makalaban na natin, and the characteristics of operations used in the planning and conduct of tactical operations. So sa mga tactical operations na to, sa mga giyera na, required by the commander in order to determine the best use of his available firepower and maneuver forces. So paano magpagdigma? So, ginagamit na ito sa digmaan, combat intelligence. Mayroon din tayong tinatawag na counter-intelligence. An integral part of all intelligence operations, and as such, cannot be separated from combat and strategic intelligence. So, laging nakakabit ito sa ibang uri ng intelligence, sa combat and strategic intelligence. Its objectives are to safeguard information against espionage, protect installations and materials from sabotage and guard against personnel engaging in subversive activities. So, kaya tinawag na counterintelligence para hindi tayo para maprotektahan natin yung mga information natin against espionage, yung mga vital installations natin para hindi tayo maatake, at yung mga materials natin maiwasan nating masabotahe. Okay? Then it concerned with the early detection of disaffected or dissident groups of individuals which constitute a threat to national security. So this is for protection, okay? For us to detect yung mga disaffected or dissident groups natin para hindi tayo magkakaroon ng tinatawag na insider threats or trusted insiders against our national security. Yan ang tinatawag na counter-intelligence. So, mayroong intelligence and counter-intelligence. We have also the so-called public safety intelligence or PUSIN, which refers to the knowledge essential to ensure the protection of lives and properties, public safety. intelligence. You also have criminal intelligence. Knowledge essential for the prevention of crimes and the investigation, arrest, and prosecution of criminal offenders. So, criminal intelligence yan. Ito na yun sa police. Okay? You also have internal security intelligence. Knowledge essential for the maintenance of peace and order. So, sa loob na natin, hindi natin concern sa labas, sa foreign intelligence. Ang concern natin is internal security intelligence. Okay. Our next topic is all about order of battle intelligence. This concern with the manner in which military forces are organized and disposed. There are different factors which are considered. First, the strength of these forces in terms of numbers of personnel, units, and types of numbers of weapons. So, ang concern natin dito, yung number of personnel, operating units natin, and the types of or numbers of weapons na gagamitin. The name and designation, the way in which they are organized, the type of equipment and weapons that they utilize, such as uniforms, machine guns, trucks, and the tactical doctrine, which is offensive plans and contingencies. There are different terminologies that we must understand the study of intelligence. We have the term log. Log means chronological records of activities that took place in the establishment under surveillance. So, yan yung mga sinusulat natin. Yan yung mga naka-record sa atin. Sa ating logbook, sa ating mga record book. Okay? Lahat ng activities na nangyari. Safe house. Safe house refers to a place where agents meet each other for purposes of debriefing and reporting. So, doon sila nagde-debrief, doon sila nagre-report. Safe house yan. So, sila lang nakakalam. We also have the term live drop. It refers to a place where agents or informants leave their messages to the other agents. So, live drop. Saan niya iiwan at saan kukunin yung informations na yun or messages na pinapadala ng agent sa kanyang handler. Then, yung term na decoy. Ang decoy, pag sinabing decoy, a person or object used by the subject in attempt to elude surveillance. Okay? So, may decoy siya. Para pag may sumusunod sa'yo, siya yung gagamitin mo para iligaw, decoy. Either way, ginagamit yan pag tayo nag-ooperate or pati yung makalaban natin, gumagamit din sila ng decoy para iligaw tayo. We also have a term convoy, an associate of the subject who follows him to detect surveillance. So, may ka-convoy, may kasama na sumusunod. Then we have the term casing. It is the careful inspection of a place to determine its suitability for a particular operational purpose, casing. So, pag sinabi mong ikinikase mo na yung isang lugar, so inoobserbahan mo na siya. Okay? Tinitignan mo, pwede bang mag-operate dito? Ano ba yung mga nandito? So, kinikasing mo na siya. Pwede bang dito gawin namin yung operation namin? May mga sagabal ba rito? Okay? Pinapag-aralan mo yung lugar. Kinikasing mo. Then we have the term elicitation. The process of extracting information from a person believes to be in possession of vital information without his knowledge or suspicion. So, nag-elicit tayo. Kumukuha tayo ng informasyon na sa isang tao na kung saan hindi niya alam, kinukunan natin siya ng informasyon. Elicitation tawag doon. Then, yung wiretapping. Wiretapping is a method of collecting information through interception of telephone or conversation. Wiretapping. Wina-wiretap natin. So, pinapakinggan natin yung usapan sa telepono, okay? Although, wiretapping is illegal. Bawal yan. Meron tayong anti-wiretapping law. Okay. Observation and description is a method of collecting information by merely using different senses. So, obserbahan natin, gamit natin ating visual, okay? Audio, pandinig, auditory, okay? Sense of smell, sense of touch, sense of touch, hearing, yan. So, observation. Cover refers to the changing, forging, or falsifying agent's real personality, including but not limited to things, job location, and other that will be used in undercover assignment. Ito yung mga nagpapanggap. Okay, papanggap na basurero, pero police pala, or military pala, papanggap na vendor. Okay, so tawag doon cover. We also have mercenary. Information for sale needed something for exchange of information. Okay, so yung mga information, may mga nagbebenta dyan. Ang tawag doon, mercenary. Okay, kailangan bilhin pa yung information. Then we have the term double crosser. He wants to get more information from the police more than he gives. So, nagdo-double cross siya. Kuha siya ng information, nagbibigay siya ng counting information, at makakuha siya ng kailangan niya ng information. Double crosser ang tawag doon. Okay? We also have informer. A person who gives information in lieu for a price or reward. So, informer ang tawag doon. Kailangan mo siyang bayaran at tawag sa kanya, informer. So, may kapalit na kabayaran yung information na bibigay niya. Pero pag informant, a person who gives information without expectation of a price or reward. Laging lumalabas sa work exam to. Walang bayad. Tawag sa kanya, informant. Libre. Okay. Cryptography is an art and science of codes and ciphers. So, yung mga secret messages. So, tawag doon sa art and science of codes and ciphers ay cryptography. Para ma-decode. Okay? Cryptography. Meron tayong cryptanalyst. Refers to those persons who break intercepted codes. So, yung mga nag-interpret, nag-break ng codes, ang tawag doon, cryptanalyst. Yung crypt intelligence, this means hidden or coded. So, ito yung mga secret messages. Crypt, ang tawag doon. So, nakatago. Okay. Cryptography, the art and science of making, devising, inventing, or protecting codes and cipher. So, pag gagawa ka ng secret codes, okay, at paano protektahan yun, tawag doon, cryptography. Cryptoanalyst, the art and science of breaking codes and ciphers, para naulit lang. Okay, decrypting, translation of intercepted messages into proper language or text. So, kung may mga coded, okay, mga secret codes na ginamit, at paano mo ito ngayon i-translate sa naiintindihan mong language, ang tawag doon, decrypting. Encrypting, transforming plain text into codes and ciphers. So, yung mga plain text naman, pag itatago mo, gagawin mo siyang codes, ang tawag doon, encrypting mo, i-encrypt mo. Then we have cryptogram or cryptograph, any message in codes and ciphers. So, any message na naka-coded, ang tawag doon, cryptogram or cryptograph. Coda, a system or words or groups of letters or symbols selected to substitute or represent other words. Coda. Parang yun yung substitution mo. Kung anong ibig sabihin niyan. Yung word na yun or yung symbols na yun. Coda, tawag doon. Okay, there are different motives of informants. Yung mga tao na nagbibigay ng information. Okay, we have vanity, civic mindedness, fear, repentance, gratitude or gain, revenge, jealousy, or remuneration. Remuneration, yung nagpapabayad. Okay, may may kapalit na monetary consideration. Jealousy, dahil sa pagsiselos, magsusumbong siya sa pinagsiselosan niya. Okay, Then revenge, kailangan niyang magiganti. Yan. May sakit siya ng loob sa isang tao, magiganti siya o sa isang organisasyon. Gratitude or gain. Ito yung mga natulungan ng pulis na nagbibigay ng permission para at least kapag bigay naman sila ng act of gratitude, parang pagpapasalamat nila. Repentance, ito yung mga nagsisisi, gusto na magbago, kaya nagbibigay na ng impormasyon. Fear, ito yung mga takot na balikan sila, patayin sila, kaya kailangan na nilang magsabi ng totoo. Then yung civic mindedness, ito yung because of being a good citizen, okay, kailangan nilang tumulong sa mga kapulisan para masawata ang isang krimen, or yung vanity, yung parang vain nila, gusto nila maging magkaroon ng kaibigang pulis, okay, magbibigay sila ng permission, okay, vanity. So punta tayo sa intelligence cycle. Ang first and foremost process or piece ng intelligence is yung data collection. The taking of information from the universe of data through covert and overt means. So, paano mag-kolekta ng impormasyon? A key strategy involved in this step is having a good understanding of data collection plan and available sources of information. So, dapat alam mo saan ka dapat kumuha, okay, ng impormasyon, sino dapat mong kunan, okay, paano mo kukunin, okay. Knowing what information is needed and where this information may be accessed is very important. So, ano yung dapat mong kunin? Ano yung importanteng information na yun? Asaan mo kukunin? So, importante yan sa data collection. Then, data evaluation. It involves the determination of the reliability and credibility of the source and the validity and accuracy of the information. The general system used to evaluate information is the Admiralty Scale. Ito na yung mga tinatawag na reliability and accuracy. Meron tayong sa reliability, by letters ito, A, B, C, D, E, F. Pag A, completely reliable, totoo, totoong totoo, usually reliable, okay, mataas ang posibilidad na totoo, fairly reliable, maaring totoo. D, not usually reliable, kung minsan hindi totoo. Then E, unreliable, hindi totoo, hindi dapat paniwalaan. Then really cannot be judged, hindi mo masabi kung totoo o hindi. While sa accuracy, numbers naman to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, confirmed by other sources, probably true, possibly true, doubtedly true, as improbable, and truth cannot be judged. So pag sinabing A1, completely reliable and confirmed by other sources, totoo, yan, accurate siya, reliable siya. So yan yung pag-evaluate ng data. Yan yun. So we have the reliability, the accuracy, at saan natin nakuha yung information na yun, yung source of information. Direct observation by other unit commander, penetration or resident agent, AP troops, interrogation of captured enemy, government civilian, members of the populace, documentary. So nice to know lang naman to. At least may makukopyahan kayo. Then yung titang na data collation. The process of organizing information for storage for retrieval at later time. So i-collate mo yung mga data, i-store mo, okay, ipa-file mo. It is the process of information that can be integrated with other existing information on a file or a new file may be created. Okay. Then this should be properly indexed, labeled, or computerized. So data collation. Then after collating, we have the so-called data analysis. This segment deals with what happens when information is received, processed, and now integrated with existing information on hand. Bits and pieces of information are now organized into forms which can be easily looked and highlight further requirements or indicate new leads. involves charting, financial profiling, graphs, and tables. Analysis requires going beyond the facts. Inferences may be made based on available facts. Strives to answer the questions who, what, when, where, and why, and how. A statement at the end of this stage called hypothesis. So pag nagkaroon na tayo ng data analysis, makakabuo na tayo ng different hypothesis. Ito yung mga naisip na natin.